The Panasonic S1 and S1R offer custom settings that can either be stored to the mode dial in custom 1, 2, or 3, or you can store custom settings to the SD card or XQD card. Let's walk through the menu and show you how we store our settings. So before we begin, let's go ahead and customize a look. What we're going to do is we're going to go into the camera's menu, and we're going to change the photo style. We're going to go to black and white for this one. We're going to do L monochrome D. And as a function of L monochrome D, we're going to add some graininess. We're going to make it look a little grainier, and we'll set that in. Now that we have that set, we go to the wrench setting, the cog within the wrench setting, also known as a gear, and we can go to save to custom mode. So from here, we can store that under C1, C2, or in this case, three different C3 settings. We're going to store this one to C1. You'll notice here, if we press this, you can even name this. So in this case, we would name this L monochrome if we would like. And we hit yes. Now we have stored that setting. And just to show you that it's been stored, we'll go back into the camera's menu. We're going to turn the photo style back off to a standard picture profile. So now we're on standard. And when I switch the mode dial to C1, we're back to our C1 setting of L monochrome. You also have the ability to take C1 and just load it in so that if you don't want to have to switch the mode dial to C1, C2, or C3, instead you just want to populate it to PAS or M, you can do that from this mode here. Simply select custom C1 and that'll populate right over. Custom mode settings, you'll notice that right now we have the ability to store to three different C3s. From custom mode settings, you can add up to 10 C3s, which means you have a total of 12 custom settings that you can program to the custom mode dial at the top. So to access those extra C3 settings, go to C3. Then from the camera's menu, you'll now see a C option tab at the top. And here's where all your extra C3 settings are. Aside from being able to customize how many additional C settings you have the ability to edit the titles for all of your C settings, so you can change the names of them. You can also choose the behavior of how things are loaded. So if you don't want it to load a different recording mode, meaning a different PAS or M mode, you can have it stay in S for shutter speed, but then just load the color profiles. Or you can have the sleep mode not change. Or you can have the turn off power function not change. You can also choose to populate the f-stop, shutter, and ISO from your custom mode. Or you can choose just to have the color profile be populated across instead. Same with white balance. You can either choose to have the camera's white balance or you can have the custom setting white balance chosen. So we also have the ability to load our settings through the SD card and store them on the SD card. This is great if you're working with multiple photographers and you want to be able to transfer the photo information from one camera over to another camera to have them all set the same. Go into Save and Restore. From here, you'll have access to storing them either on the XQD slot or the SD card slot. We're going to go ahead and choose the SD card slot. From here, you select Save, New File, and you can actually name this. So if you wanted this one to be named Cam1 or Cam2, you could do that. We're just going to go ahead and set it under that. And now that's been stored on the SD card. To load from the SD card, simply select the card where you have your settings set. Select load, and all of them will be stored right here. You'll be able to see if there were four or five different settings that you've set. Simply select, in this case, cam one set, and now it's load all the settings from camera one. And finally, if you wanted to delete settings that were on the SD card, simply go to delete, select what you'd like to delete, and now those settings are no longer on the SD card. And those are the custom settings and also the way that you can store your settings to a memory card for the S1 and S1R.